whole lot of things is happening in the world.
Why don't like stringy mango?
Why I don't like stringy mango? Yeah. I don't know. Do you think about it?
I mean, you can't clean your teeth. Get a floss.
That's not how it works.
All right. So we're starting with the vaccination blitz that starts tomorrow.
Yeah.
The Ministry of Health will host a special blitz at the National Arena on Saturday, starting at 10 a.m. for those who are due their second dose of the COVID-19 vaccine. So from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m., I think it's in the National Arena. So I guess call ahead and see what's happening, because there'll also be the Destiny Series track and field in the National Stadium. So call ahead to see what's going on, mm-hmm, and make sure you have the right
information. Yep. Yeah, especially the driving and the parking in the right place, because we tend to get mixed up when we go out there. So
can't manage
that. You go over there for your vaccine, you end up
in a track meet.
Well, the Office of Disaster Preparedness and Emergency Management, ODPEM, is reporting that Cays have been reopened. The Cays, that is, have been reopened, but for beach activities only. So earlier this year, the days were closed. That's the beach Cays, of course, were closed. I made reports of boats and other parties increasing the risk of COVID-19 spread. So the beach were open. People were going there, not wearing masks, not social distancing, and the numbers were going up. A warning was issued that persons found in breach will be prosecuted under the Disaster Risk Management Act as well. I think when people go to the beach, like, they're outside and they're thinking, oh, but we're outside already. Like, why we need masks? You know what I mean? We can laugh and talk and nobody they're near to me and, you know?
I mean, so what constitutes as beach activities? Because I'm going to go in my nice little shorts and my nice little shirt, and I go have my mask the entire time, because I don't see how a boat party will increase the numbers, but being on the beach won't. I mean, it's...
Well, maybe they're thinking that on the beach you have more space, so you can find a little space for yourself. Because I've been to the beach since the lockdown, and the beaches that were permitted to be open, that is. And inside the curfew hours, of course. Yes, before curfew, long before curfew, which because we had early morning, these living, things. Living but the private beaches that I've been to, that I paid to go inside. Mm-hmm. And even when we went to the hotels saying.
Stop while you're
No, listen, I'm just saying, I don't go anywhere Bandulu, because my name not calling. But anyways, even when we go to the hotels as well, they'll tell you, like, you know, you have to be seated in a particular area.
Yeah.
And they are very strict on these things as well. Well, the hotels that I've been to, they're very strict on this.
Yeah, tour the island. Well, I love the
egg. No, you find some time. Like, it was, Mother's, you know.
So I go on a boat party, you know, and it's 12 of you. We can't spread up on the boat.
And the 12 people alone upon the boat
ride. No, but towards my yacht.
How many people do you think, oh, Lord, let me not even bother calling names. I don't want to call no names.
No, man, you can't.
But there was
call
a boat ride that was a part of a list of events to happen for a particular party series.
In the West of Jamaica.
How many persons do you think that were on that?
I mean, I can't count, you know, so my math is terrible.
So that's what I'm saying. So when you rub up against people, you know, the party vibes and stuff, you may just be contracting COVID.
No, just roll up on one person. You go one person, you roll up on one person.
Or you go hold on for some of them, just hold on for a while.
No, just go roll up on one person. When I go on a boat, I'm sitting at the middle, you know. I don't go near the sides or anything.
That's because of your fear of drowning.
No matter. I obey all the protocols.
Anyways.
So, just a reminder, obey all protocols under the Disaster Risk Management Enforcement Orders. 2, wear a mask in all public spaces.
Yes. 3,
sanitize and wash your hands as often as possible. You know, I think in a couple of years from now, and it's a maintain physical distance of 6 feet. You know, I think a couple of years from now, that's all we'll hear. Like, even sitting down, you're
still?
Hear. Social distance. Wear your mask, wash your hands. Like, that's all.
You think that in a couple of years, this is going to still be the narrative?
What do you mean? It's not going to change.
You think so?
Yeah, man. It's not going to change.
So how are they reopening other parts of the world without...
I'm not saying that reopening is going to stop it. Like, in the back of your mind, people are going to be conscious of you. Oh, boy.
Like, in a subconscious way?
Yeah.
Right.
Conscious or subconscious way.
Okay.
Yeah. You like.
Like, in the back of your head, say, okay, man, if you come too close to you because, and I don't need to hug you up because maybe you didn't wash your hands. Or I'm like,
true.
Did you wash your hands?
I don't like hug people, really, unless I'm a family.
You don't like hugging people?
No, I do. I do love hugging people.
I have problems.
You like crawfish? Crayfish?
Crayfish?
Yeah.
Yes.
You like shrimp?
Oh, God, yes.
Yes, I want to say a special good morning to the people at Middle Quarters.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man, big them up, man.
Other day, I was going down, I'm a lady, I stopped, you know. I buy a little bag of shrimp. I said, oh.
You bought a little bag of shrimp?
Yeah.
You go to Middle Quarters to buy a little bag of shrimp,
do it? I meant to buy a little bag, you know. She see me, she said, no, man, you can't buy a little bag.
How many times do you pass through Middle Quarters? You have to buy big amounts and carry go home and carry for give way to?
No, because I go and come back.
Oh, okay.
It's 2 times. So I buy for go. She said, no, man, carry a big car. I think it's Simone. Her name is Simone, and I want to tell her thanks.
Okay. So, nice, so you get free shrimp and I bring back none?
It did done along the way.
Hi, team.
You know, for
Excel went out and brought him for himself and didn't bring back.
All right.
Authorities, guys, have confirmed.
Wow.
Is that 130 students?
136.
Is that 136? Okay, my prompt is cut off. So 136 students were abducted by gunmen in northern Nigeria earlier this week, including some as young as 5 years old, the school's owner said on Thursday. That is crazy.
I tell people all the time, you know, you see this is a place where me live? I love it. Because they say things like that happening, because they do that and they turn these children into child soldiers. Majority of them become child soldiers and in refugee camps after. And it's just a whole, it's a whole craziness. And just to think about it, think about us being in at Woolmer's or at Clarendon and
Clarendon College. Yes,
sorry,
please.
Sorry.
Thank you so much. Yes, you were saying.
The false CC. Anyways.
Huh?
So imagine you're at school and then somebody just, people just come and just grab them up. Like,
I can't imagine
it. No, man.
I really can't.
You play a dandy shandy and somebody just, you just jump, cock up his attendant and somebody just grab you.
What is happening this morning? What is really happening this morning, guys? What is happening this morning?
What's the next one?
Mercy, the Office of Disaster Preparedness and Emergency Management, ODPEM.
Is it ODPEM? Why not ODPEM?
It's ODPEM.
Okay.
Anyways, was strongly criticized on Wednesday after it was revealed that the agency had a backlog of 280 applications spanning 2013 to 2020. The chairman of the Parliament's Public Administration and Appropriation Committee, PAAC, Michael Phillips, wondered aloud, how do you do that on Wednesday, whether some of the nearly 300 projects had been approved and construction completed without the knowledge of ODPEM.
Well, I wonder which beach they go. I wonder which hotel they go over there.
You want me to show you a picture?
No, I'm just saying that. That's why you wonder aloud. Like Phillips.
Oh, I'm just saying loudly.
Say, you know, just wonder.
And just say wonder loudly.
Yeah, because you see, and things like that happen so often in this country that things just go amiss and it's like nobody answers. There's no, as a lady would always say, heads must roll, no head rolls. You know, so these things happen and then you're like, you ask a question and in 9 days, it's on the forefront and then poof, gone, something else takes the place. It's crazy.
It's nothing new.
Yeah, but we have to change that though. Like, that has to change.
You see, every time we have discussions like this, that is the ending statement. It has to change.
But you know why?
It has to change. Something must happen. My thing is, right? Mm-hmm. You have a backlog. Most of these places need to just step up with technology to kind of get more efficient in how they handle things like this.
Man,
it's as simple as getting Excel.
Yeah, like
well, I'm Excel, saying, Excel it's as simple as getting Excel.
Yeah, but we're going to a digital space now, so we have to, you know.
We have to get with the times, man.
The All right, that's it for trending topics this morning. Let us know what you think on our social media platforms, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Debbie's WhatsApp. Ha ha ha!